Hello everyone. My name is Cansu Calik. I am very happy to be here and to be a part of the project. And shortly I want to introduce myself. I am 26 years old, and after getting my high school diploma from Onda Kuzmayız High School, I studied translation and interpreting at Yeditepe University for 2 years. Now I am the senior student at Onda Kuzmayız University in the Department of English Language Teaching. And as I learned more and more about language teaching, I started to have some interest to teach, to learn more ways to teach to learners, especially to young adults. And now I work in a kindergarten as an English teacher. And beside my education in college, my favorite thing is to experience different cultures and travel around the world. So that's why I've chosen my. That's why I've chosen my topic. And let's look at my topic. I'm going to talk about my project. And the first point is about why I attend the project. And social justice is extremely important to me. I believe that social justice is necessary to heal the devices that plague our nation and also the world. Social justice helps us work toward celebrating diversity in our communities and country. It is another thing to acknowledge that each of us has a different stories. Those stories must be respected by our communities, and by doing so, we create more cohesive and tight communities, societies. And everyone deserves basic human rights and to be living a happy life, but unfortunately, not every person can. The society that we live in today makes it especially difficult for people of color, women, LGBTQ members, people with disabilities, and people in certain religions, or poor, or lower class, people, or any person who is a part of marginalized group. If everyone understood what social justice was and put true value in it, our world wouldn't have wars, poverty, hate, fear, inequality, and not as many people would be living with mental illnesses. We have a lot to do before reaching this point, but it all starts with educating people on why social justice is so necessary and all the issues that it covers. This explains why I attended this project as a teacher. It all starts with educating people on why social justice is so important. And I believe that it is my responsibility as a teacher to contribute to that mission. And next point, I want to tell you my project with details. I worked with two kindergartens, and there are 16 students in each kindergarten, and they're about 5 and 6 years old. First of all, I introduced them 8 different cultures, so the countries, and they are Italy, South Africa, the United States, Russia, Japan, Turkey, India, and Australia. After being exposed to other cultures, I want them to draw a picture of a child where they want around the world and make up a story for their characters. And they created their own English storybooks as a class. And these two kindergarten send their storybooks to each other as a gift in Children's Day. And before, and why I've chosen these cultures? Because I want to pick them from different continents, from North America, Europe, Asia, Africa, and Australia. And you may ask it, why young learners? And let me explain it. Because, as you know, the tree is bent, so grows the tree. As research shows that children's values, self-confidence, and behavioral patterns are shaped very early age. In very early age, if we want our city and religion and our nation to be populated by tolerant and responsible adults, we should teach them by being a model. If a child lives with fairness, he learns justice. And I will move on to how intercultural awareness and social justice are related. We are teachers, or are we teachers? Are we activities managers, language facilitation units, or babysitters? Intercultural learning gives the teacher a role, not only as one or more of these, but also as an educator. This makes many teachers feel uncomfortable. Above all, with the idea that may be influencing our students in some way. Are we responsible for transmitting some kind of ideology to our students? No. We are helping them to become more aware of the world around them and to better interact with the world. And I think these are the crucial roles of teacher. We recognize that there are structural inequalities in our society which systemically disadvantage people of color, poor people, and people with other marginalized identities. We further recognize that institutions such as schools are complicit in these inequalities, and that it is therefore our responsibility to work to actively resist injustice and to create a school where everyone is welcome, valued, and safe. Otherwise, cultural differences leading to discrimination and racism can have an impact on children's well-being. Intercultural awareness is quite simply having an understanding of both your own and the other cultures, and particularly similarities and differences between them. And cultural differences leading to discrimination and racism can have an impact on children's well-being. And another important point is my aims and objectives. The first one is my aim is to develop intercultural sensitivity and awareness, to cultivate intercultural attitudes which include being tolerant, respectful, curious, and empathetic towards other cultures, to acquire culture knowledge, both culture general and culture specific, to notice differences and foster acceptance and understanding, to empathy and understand people different from ourselves is the key and break down the barriers. And duration, the project lasts 1 month and a half. Actually, teaching and exposing the students to the target culture lasts a month. Then students draw pictures and make up their stories, and it lasts like about 15 days. And now I want to go over the process. You can skip. Okay. Role play activity is one of the our activities in the kindergarten. This one activity allows children to become more to become world travelers, and they also learn that diversity is all around them. As a role play activity, students work in pairs. They choose their country which they want to go, and they greet each other and buy tickets to any country they want. And my other activity is we celebrate holidays and festival of the target culture. Children love a good party. Teaching them about cultural and religious celebrations around the world is a great way to get children excited about the diversity. A cultural celebration can reveal a lot about its deeply held values and traditions. For example, to teach Indian culture, I arrange an Indian wedding ceremony. Students act as an Indian people. Can you play it? Yeah, it's a video. No, this one is video. Italian masks. And the other activity is to teach Japanese culture. I arrange a tea ceremony in the class. We will show them in the video. And not now. And I also use books, because books offer a great opportunity to teach kids about different countries and cultures. Even just to get them to say unfamiliar names. I use a number of books to teach the target culture. I also used maps and globe. The use of a globe or a flat map helps students realize how big the world is. I used a world map both at the beginning of the project to make them aware of the number of the countries and continents. And also, I use it during the project to show them where is the target country. We also had many art activities to teach the target cultures. Art is no longer removed from the learning, as you know. And to teach the target culture, I gave them colored pages with the items, with the cultural items, and to teach the target culture, I gave them craft activities. For example, they create an evil eye with colored papers for turkey. And to practice Japanese culture, they also make a cat with origami folding. And they decorated Italian masks with tinsels, stickers, feathers. They create an elephant using paper plate, you can see in the picture. And they create an African drum using paper glass. And they make folding paper fun for Japanese culture. We will see the other pictures in the process video later. And also, one specific activity that has proven successful in the acquisition of intercultural competence is experiencing another culture. Miss Sarah came to the kindergarten and teach them her culture. We arranged Thanksgiving Day and we made Thanksgiving cards to them. And also to experience Indian culture, I taught students how to do yoga. And I also used songs and dance. We listened to different traditional musics. Kids love Seven Continents song most, and they were singing the song even when they are eating. And dance introduced children to the magical diversity of our world's population. I also taught them Indian, African, Turkish, and Russian folk dances. We also played games to teach the target culture, to expand students' understanding of people from different cultures. We played Japanese game called Go. We played Turkish hopscotch. We played chess, which is very famous in Russia. And also, I used many videos because if kids can visualize how other people live, they are more likely to understand more about different cultures. Seeing pictures in books or watching documentaries about other groups of people will enable students to experience what is important to cultures. And we watched sight videos, food and animal documentaries, and also cartoons. You can see it is Mr. Bean pizza shop. I use it to teach Italian culture. And now we will watch a video of our project process. And the next point is the result of the project. And students understand that people around the world are just like them, and they have empathy for those people. They told me, like, this little boy likes soccer just like me, or this child is enjoying a book just like me. They are now aware of that people in the world look different, wear different clothes, eat different foods, listen to different music, and more. And creating their own storybooks build resilience. Writing stories allows children to find a voice to express thoughts, feelings, fears, and experiences. It builds confidence and provides an emotional outlet for many children. Thanks to the project, their concentration span increased. And as you can see the names of the book, Peace at Home and Peace in the World, the quote of Mustafa Kemal Atatürk, and I wanted to show you how beautiful it is when differences come together. And I also wanted to talk about the disadvantages while I am creating the project. And kids' lessons tend to be fairly simple in content and geared toward the students' age and grade level. So it was a little bit challenging for me to prepare a lesson plan. And also kids were pretty quickly jump at any opportunity to get out of their seats. And so getting them to focus and learn was a challenge. And also the duration was not enough, I think, for this project, because it would be better to have one team in a month, maybe, like one country or one culture in a month. And also, I want to add the advantages. Kids do feel a sense of freedom because they are not aware of being judged. So the lack of a filter allows creativity to flow more freely. And it was an advantage for me. And teaching very young learners was a rewarding experience, and it provides invaluable skills to these learners as they progress through their education and onto their future careers. And also they are a lot more willing to learn new things and use language spontaneously. And at the end, all 32 children became so happy when they see their gifts coming from the other kindergarten. And it was a rewarding experience for me. I'm so grateful for giving me and the kids the opportunity. It was a very rewarding experience for me, and thank you so much. Do you have any questions or suggestions for me? Actually, the kindergarten in the city center, their English level is very good. Yeah, they could explain me why they wanted to do. And okay, I of course helped them. but they could easily understand what I mean. But in the kindergarten in the village, actually, they were like telling me the stories, and I just translate them because it was not possible for them to write an English story. Of course, actually, 2 hours in a day, I went to kindergarten in the city center. And I went to kindergarten in the village like 6 hours in a week. So I was teaching both of them. Yeah, and we also and also their teacher helped me when. I didn't go to the kindergarten.
Actually, maybe it was you with the teacher, I mean, instructing intercultural communication or competence, not the teacher who was teaching these students, right?
No, actually, 6 hours in a week, I went to the village, which is very far away from Samsun's center. Yeah. Do you have any question or? Yeah, actually, I bought the same materials for them, and yeah, they did the same activities.
Were all the pictures from the one school? Were most of the pictures from the city center school?
Actually, that is why I could just took pictures from the kindergarten in the village because they were very shy, and when I took the videos. They didn't wanna do something, that's why I couldn't take any video, but I took many pictures of them. Yeah.
So when I think about thank you first of all. When I think about your goal of teaching intercultural awareness to that age group, I think of open-mindedness. As a concept, and how as we grow older, we have less of it. Mm-hmm. And I think about kids that age teaching me more in some ways than what I perhaps can teach them. Did you learn something from working with that age group on this particular topic with regard to their approach to intercultural awareness?
Actually, I didn't expect them, they would understand me that much. Like, when I taught them, I was not sure that they fully understood me. But at the end, they were just like, while drawing the pictures, I didn't tell them anything. They were just like, teacher, I want to draw a picture. A man in like black skin, and also for Africa, I want to draw many animals like I saw in the videos, in the animal videos. So I want to draw them. So I didn't expect them. They just fully understood of me. But when they were drawing the stories and creating the stories also, I don't know if you have a chance to read the stories, but I was very shocked by the results. So I learned many things from them. I was shocked, like, I didn't expect they would fully understood me, like, what I was trying to do. But they just, like, comment on, teacher, this boy loves playing soccer like me, or this girl lives like me, and they just see what I wanted to do, and they helped me.
I guess my follow-up is you've done this now with these classes. Do you think it's going to continue? Is there a teacher going, the teachers that were there that you worked with, are they going to try and continue these kinds of activities?
Actually, when I talk about my project, they told me that we also want to apply in our classes, so can you give me the lesson plans? Maybe, and I told them, please don't apply like me, because the limitation of the time, I'm doing the process like that, but don't follow me, because maybe I told them, you can have just one team in a month, and I gave advice to them. And also in the kindergarten, in the city center, I worked there. So I will go on my studies.
So, may have misunderstood. Do you have lesson plans for this?
Yeah, I have. Yeah, just because of the time limitation, it will be like 8 lesson plans. So I just divided to the activities. Like games, music, songs. Thank you, everybody. Can you tell me? I'm sorry.
Do you have any plan to apply the same content to a different age group? You know, because for their age, it's very difficult for them to make connections, to activate their schema.
Mm-hmm.
So do you think that if you apply to a different age group, that the results will be different?
Of course it will, and also my activities will be very different, because even in primary school I can't apply this lesson plan because it's for the kindergarten, so the results will be also very different from it.
One is going to be studying just only young learners, and the other is going to be ELT. So you are
possibly a very
young learner teacher.
But yeah, actually, I do love the youngsters more. So, yeah, I'm in the...
This is what Billy told about satisfaction.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Yeah, exactly.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.